Major Wildcats, welcome back to the first episode of Wildcat TV Junior for this school year. I'm former Puma, Emily Caton. Just like last year, we'll be highlighting a different elementary school each month. To start the school year off, our first main highlight is John Nowlin. Let's see what those nights have to show for us.
For our first main highlight this year, we have John Nowlin Elementary, home of the Knights.
All right, welcome to John Nowlin Elementary School. We are glad to start the year this year. Hopefully everyone's having a great start to their school year. We're going to highlight a couple of our new clubs here at John Nowlin, and we have a group of students from next door that comes over and reads with our kindergarten first grade students. So have a great day, and it's a great day to be a Knight.
The Ames facilitator, Miss Go, loves to see the progress of the kids throughout the years. We were able to get an interview with her, and let's see what she has to say.
It's a weekly thing we do. We come over and we read with our kindergarten and first grade buddies, and it's really awesome throughout the year to see the elementary students grow as readers. So at the beginning of the year, our kindergarten students are primarily telling us the stories through the pictures, and we're doing the reading. But by the end of the school year, the kindergartners are typically reading to us. So it's exciting to watch them grow as readers, and it also gives our students an opportunity to be leaders with our J&E nights across the parking lot. So we love being here.
I love coming here because I get to read to wonderful, beautiful children, kindergartners and first graders especially. It's just a nice bonding experience, and just reading to them and then having them read to you, it's just adorable. Do you like books?
Uh-huh. Reading books has pictures, being quiet, and they'll bother other people because they read the books.
And because it makes it easier for me and other people to learn. It helps us like not be like afraid of like other people like out in the real world.
They help me read. With this, we're starting with a chart to read books that also have specific words.
Because I like Pete the Cat a lot. Books. And I like all different books.
Yeah, I like the nut one too.
Next up, we have two interviews about Character Club.
Hi, I'm Flora, and I am a member of the Character Club. So every month we have a character trait. And so we make posters telling what it's about. So we describe the character trait of the month, and then we put on a cute little skit, like a play, like kind of giving an example of what it is. We're working on a skit to represent SAFE. We'll be putting it on for the whole school at the end of the month.
Character Club is where we go into my classroom. One of the words is respectful. Respectful means like quiet in the hallway, not talk when the teacher's talking. You should join Character Club because it's fun. You get to be with friends and you draw.
For our last thing, we have Girls on the Run.
Girls on the Run is a club that you can join to run around and get activities. And I feel like you make a lot more friends in it and meet more people from different grades.
My favorite thing so far that we've done is we ran around and they'd ask us questions, and we'd have a medium, easy, hard, and we'd get to explain why. And I feel like it made us connect more and see people that have the same struggles or people that don't have the same struggles. Not only do you get to do activities and run around, but you do get to make more friends, and I feel like we have some of the best staff to teach us to do those things.
So in Girls on the Run, we basically, we're running, obviously, but we do different activities with each other. We have groups sometimes, and it's a fun way for us to interact with each other. My favorite thing is Star Power, and what we were doing in Star Power, we started to run from one bus lane to the other, and every time we did one lap, we would write on a poster something to encourage and brighten up somebody else's star power. And star power is about feeling good in yourself and feeling good in others.
Thanks, J&E. Keep up the amazing work. Signing off, it's Addie Kincaid-Chilcutt. Back to Emily in the studio.
Looks like they're having a lot of fun already this school year. Just like with our main highlight, we have our inspirational quote and creative highlight. and it looks like the William Yates Bulldogs have some pretty creative students. Let's head to them for some creative sparks.
What's up, Junior Wildcats? I was able to meet with Alan and Keelan with their creative thoughts. Let's go check it out.
My name is Kellen Lovingood.
And my name is Alan Robles.
So this is our school flag. Everybody in the school has a flag, and these circles represent like everybody in our class, and we take this flag to like team rallies, and stellar like means like cool, awesome, and amazing. And then we like put like a pole through it, and we like carry it to team rallies with us.
We had to do a rough draft first, and then she gave us some time to make our circles, and we all like put what you wanted, like what you wanted. This is my picture of my memories. I drew like how like I did my stuff. So here I put my house, and over here is my school, and we had a playground right here. And over here there was a lake, and me and my dad went fishing, and I caught my first fish. And next to my house, and I like to go there in the summer.
So this is like my memories, but so we like put, we get like 5 memories, and we make it like, we turn it and we narrow it down to one that we like a lot, and we can like write about it a lot, and we put it into like a story, and then and it's also important to like have memories, because like you get to think about like all the good memories from like back then.
Man, that's way better than anything I could do. Now it's time for some Supercast to show us the quotes they have for us.
Hi, my name's Brianna Soriano.
Hi, my name's Liliana Roderick.
You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, smarter than you think, and loved more than you know.
I believe that lots of people say, do not look down on others, but you also can't look down on yourself. And also, you're your worst enemy, so know that you are enough and you're perfect the way you are.
Thanks, Supercats. It's now time for our word of the month. Each month, we'll pick a new word for you guys to learn about. Asia has this month's word of the month.
Hi guys, my name is Asia. You guys like positive words? Well, this month's word is motivation. Motivation is a general desire or commitment for someone to do something. My favorite way to motivate myself is by creating goals. If you create goals, you can see exactly what you need to do and when. My goal this year is to get good grades. So my goals are going to class and focusing. Back to Emily in the studio.
Last year, we took a look at all of the cool opportunities that the high school has, but this year, we decided to travel to the middle schools to see what they have. Annabelle and Zoe, take it away.
Thanks, Emily.
Hey, future Wildcats. Former Knight and Leopard Zoe here.
And I'm former Puma Annabelle.
Today, we're going to be looking at some of the music classes over at the middle school.
Let's go.
Band is a great way to learn how to play music with other people. One of the neat things about any music class is you get to work with other people in a way that's really meaningful. In band, you get to also master new equipment. You don't need any prior experience, whether it's trombone, or I've got my flute and trumpet here too, saxophone, percussion, horn. We've got lots of different things you can start on, lots of different things you can switch to. You can play music for the rest of your life.
Incoming sixth graders should join choir because one, it's super fun. Two, I think it's really empowering. There's a lot of people in this class and in other classes that, you know, started off really quiet in sixth grade and ended up being really outgoing, awesome people by eighth grade. We do a lot of fun things. We perform at Worlds of Fun. We succeed. We make awesome music, and we build a family.
Fifth graders should definitely join orchestra because you get to learn one of four amazing instruments, violin, viola, cello, or bass. You get to make new friends throughout middle and high school. We get to go on trips once you get to high school, and it's a great chance for you to learn a new and valuable skill.
Fifth graders should join the band program because music is awesome, and it's something that you can do and enjoy for your entire life.
Why you should join choir when you come to Brittany Hill Middle School. We have so much fun. Hey, you don't have to carry an instrument. You get to work with your voice every day. We use our bodies. We move around. We aren't stuck in chairs a lot of the time. It's really low pressure. I never ask kids to sing by themselves. I always have everybody sing all together, and we have a really great time.
I think you fifth graders should join honors choir because Miss Avery is the best teacher ever.
I think you should join choir because it's just a fun class in general.
When signing up for middle school classes in the spring, choose either intro to band, intro to orchestra, or intro to choir. Wow, that was so informative.
Yeah, I had a lot of fun learning about those classes. Now back to you in the studio.
Thanks, guys. Imani has some trivia for us.
Hello, my name is Imani Black. Did you guys know that fall started a few days ago, September 23rd? Are you guys ready for those pretty fall colors? Well, this month's trivia question is, why do some leaves change colors in the fall? Teachers, if you guys want to participate, please research the right answer and email it to wctvtrivia@gmail.com. You guys' classes will be entered into a drawing, and the winner will have their class picture highlighted in next month's episode.
You know, I started school year off pretty great. I got to see all my friends and get all my new classes. But enough about me. Some Knights over at John Nowlin are going to share with us some things they've enjoyed for the start of the school year so far.
You already saw John Nowlin during the highlight, but while we were there, we also asked kids what they enjoyed about the school year so far, and here were the answers.
What has been your favorite part about the school year so far?
Honestly, my favorite part of this year so far is probably the teachers. They're so nice. Shout out to Miss Hansen. She is so nice.
That I have some good friends.
Favorite part is my teacher.
Getting to meet all my new friends.
School elections, like student council.
That we get to be the leaders of the school and open up new opportunities for us.
This is my first year, and I'm happy with my teacher that I have. I'm probably seeing all my friends again this year.
We have friends and family, I know.
Was our science experiments that we do.
Meeting my new teacher.
Coming up here reading to the kids.
Wow, it seems that everyone has had a great start to the school year.
Our episode's almost over, but first, here's some news around the district.
Hey future Wildcats, it's time for some shoutouts around the district. James Walker Elementary is having a fundraiser on Monday, October 2nd from 5 to 8 at the Independence Crumble Cookie. James Walker Elementary is celebrating Career Week on October 9th through the 13th. James Walker Elementary will be having a Culver's Night on Tuesday, October 10th from 5 to 8 at the Blue Springs Culver's. Shout out to Sunny Point Elementary Student Incentive Board. Awesome job on your speeches, and we are excited for you this year. Sunny Point Elementary will be having their school carnival on October 7th from 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. Shout out to Miss Trueblood's Exploratory and Bachelor class. Sunny Point and Paul Kinder have created Grizzly and Puma Buddies. Students in Miss Trueblood's Ambassadors class will be working with Sunny Point Elementary kids. We are very excited to begin our journey at Sunny Point Elementary with Paul Kinder Middle School Buddies throughout the year. On September 15th, Lucy Franklin Elementary had their Fun Run fundraiser. They are trying to raise enough money for Casey Wolf to visit our school. They were able to reach a goal last year, so this year should be no problem. Lucy Franklin and family partnered with a local Boy Scout troop to build a Gaga ball pit at Lucy Franklin Elementary. The students have been learning the rules of the game with Coach Chavnor in PE. They have loved being able to play Gaga ball at recess this year.
Well, future Wildcats, that's all we have for this first episode. If you didn't see your school this month, don't worry, we'll be around to see you. And remember, it has been, is, and always will be a great day to be a future Wildcat. Woo!